औज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि बरकातुहू। इज़ इट परमिसेबल टू गिव उधिया और कुर्बानी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ वंस डिसीज्ड पेरेंट्स और एनी रिलेटिव्स और ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम? इज़ दिस परमिसेबल और इज़ दिस अ इनोवेशन? लेट्स सी द डिटेल ऑफ इट। इट इज़ नॉट प्रिस्क्राइब्ड to offer or give udhiya or qurbani on behalf of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because that was not narrated from any of the sahaba, despite their perfect love for him and their perfect eagerness to do good. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not instruct his ummah to do that, and as he instructed them to send blessings upon and to pray, like we do durood on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But this is the thing, it was never mentioned, and never Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked them to do, like once he is not in this world, to do on his behalf. So sahaba ikram companion never did it. What about our parents or the deceased person who is not in this world? Can we give udhiya or qurbani on behalf of them? Their udhiya is offered on their behalf, there is no such narration, because we have seen Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their own family, like Hamza radhiyallahu anhu and Khadija radhiyallahu anha and Hazrat Zainab radhiyallahu anha. There's so many people from his family, they passed away, but he never gave udhiya or qurbani on behalf of them. Not a single narration regarding that matter that says that he has given on behalf of them. And if is there any narration that is da'if, that is a weak narration. Da'if means weak narration. There is no such thing. And people are doing because they don't have knowledge, or they are doing culturally. So one is not allowed from the sunnah to do anything regarding the deceased person separately. But one thing notice, if you are doing for the family and you are intending for the deceased also, that is okay. That is okay, because the charity, whenever we put money in the charity box or any good deed we are doing it, we do it for the deceased person also, whether own parents or grandparents, so on so forth. So charity is allowed, but many people, they say this is the best charity. Many people, they ask question, I mean to say, like, can we do this best charity on behalf of our parents? They are deceased, they are no more in this world, as a sadaqa. Sadaqa throughout the year you can do it, there is no such limit not to do it. But for this, the meat of the udhiya or qurbani is particularly for the people who are alive. And we have seen, like, you know, when we take the fatwa of Sheikh Osmia, he said this is for the people who are alive. It's for a hayya, not for the mayyit, not for the dead. But as I mentioned, one can have the intention already in the whole family, but not separately. And sadaqa can be given throughout the year, throughout the time. There is no such limit for the sadaqa. And many people, they compare this thing with the Hajjul Badal. They think that when a deceased person, he or she didn't do the Hajj on behalf of them, somebody else is doing the Hajj. The same thing they think they can do on behalf of the deceased person doing the Qurbani. There is no such narration. Sahaba Ikram never did. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never did. As a thing, like, you know, regarding Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he give two rams, one for the whole family, including everyone in the family, and the another ram he gave it for the ummah. Subhanallah, that was the thing mentioned. So there is no such narration regarding giving for the deceased or giving for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Jazakallah khairat kaseera.